Christ be beside me, Christ be before me, Christ be behind me, King of my heart. Christ be within me, Christ be below me, Christ be above me, on my right hand, Christ on my left hand, Christ all around me, shield in my strife, Christ in my sleeping, Christ in my sitting, Christ in my rising, light of my life.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, we are before the Lord this day, Thursday of the 29th week in ordinary time. Say thank you for the gift of this day as a special blessing on each and every one of us. In this Mass, we are requested to pray in a special way for special intention of SPJ parishioners, so for all of us. So we now take a minute to add a private intention for this Mass in the silence of our hearts. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I've done and what I've failed to do. through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ have mercy. Lord have mercy. Let us pray. Almighty ever living God, grant that we may always conform our will to yours and serve your majesty in sincerity of heart. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, I am speaking in human terms because of the weakness of your nature. For just as you presented the parts of your bodies as slaves to impurity and to lawlessness for lawlessness, so now present them as slaves to righteousness for sanctification. For when you were slaves of sin, you were free from righteousness. But what profit did you get then from the things of which you are now ashamed? For the end of those things is death. But now that you have been freed from sin and have become slaves of God, the benefit that you have leads you to sanctification, and its end is eternal life. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus, our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Response to all your song. Blessed are they who hope in the Lord.
Blessed are they who hope in the Lord.
Blessed are the man who follows not the counsel of the wicked, nor walks in the ways of sinners, nor sits in the company of the insolent, but delights in the law of the Lord and meditates on his law day and night.
Blessed are they who hope in the Lord.
He is like a tree planted near running water that yields its fruit in due season, and whose leaves never fade. Whatever he does prospers.
Blessed are they who hope in the Lord.
Not so the wicked, not so. They are like chaff which the wind drives away. For the Lord watches over the way of the just, but the way of the wicked vanishes.
Blessed are they who hope in the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia.
I consider all things so much rubbish that I may gain Christ and be found in him.
Alleluia,
alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus said to his disciples, I have come to set the earth on fire, and how I wish it were already blazing. There is a baptism with which I must be baptized, and how great is my anguish until it is accomplished. Do you think that I have come to establish peace on the earth? No, I tell you, but rather division. From now on, a household of five will be divided, three against two and two against three. A father will be divided against his son, and a son against his father. A mother against her daughter, and a daughter against her mother. A mother-in-law against her daughter-in-law, and a daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law. The Gospel of the Lord.
Blessed be the Lord Jesus Christ.
My beloved sisters and brothers, the readings of today are emphasizing something very profound: the need to avoid moral addiction to evil. It's easy to be addicted to evil. Many of our young people today are in problem because of moral addiction to evil, from one little thing to so many things, and before you know it, they are lost. Because when you are morally addicted to evil, then you are too weak in the face of temptation. You standing for yourself in the face of temptation becomes a problem. So that's why Jesus is putting it the way he's putting it. That if we are not rooted, we are not grounded in love, in justice and peace, we are not grounded in these things, then anything can happen. So that's why Jesus is saying, do you think I have come to bring peace on earth? Because we'll be divided. People who are not committed to goodness, to justice, to peace, will be blown up in any direction. So that's why he's saying that life is like the stairs. Are you going up or going down? It depends on you, at the point you are standing. So if you are standing for Christ, you always find the way, because it's always the way. So we pray that God help us to believe in Christ, live in Christ, and find life in Christ. And we will be always blessed in everything. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Peace. May we stand to proclaim our petition to the Lord. With hope in the abundance, goodness of our loving God, we bring to him our cares and concerns. That the Holy Spirit may enrich the church with abundance of vocation to the priesthood and consecrated life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those suffering oppression throughout the world may experience the peace of Christ in their lands and in their lives, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who cannot practice their faith openly, may be upheld and strengthened through the outpouring of the Holy Spirit. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
That Christ may heal any division we may experience in this faith community and bless us with peace and joy. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
That all who have died, especially people who have died in our families, may be united with Christ in heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Peace in the silence of our hearts, may we add other private intentions. God our Father, we bring these requests to you in trust and humility. Bless and guide us always in your goodness and peace. We ask it through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands
for the praise of the Lord God's name, for our good
and for the Holy Church.
Grant us, Lord, we pray, a sincere respect for your gifts, that through the purifying action of your grace, we may be cleansed by the very mysteries we serve, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And
lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in goodness you created man, and when he was justly condemned, in mercy you redeemed him to Christ our Lord. Through him, the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore, and powers tremble before you. Heavens and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exaltation. May our voices with great joy with theirs in humble praise as we are clear.
Holy,
holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like they do fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and gave him thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory." With the first acclamation, the mystery of faith, we proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis our Pope, Timothy our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, our spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be God's eternal life, may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
The Savior's command and form by divine teaching began to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ, for the kingdom of God. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostle, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer to each other a sign of love and peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word.
Yeah.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that benefiting from participation in heavenly things, we may be helped by what you give in this present age and prepared for the gifts that are eternal, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So we thank God for the gift of this day and for the gift of your presence at this Mass, as God bless and protect and guide us today and every day. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.